Hello children, how are you all? Yes, children, we all speak different kind of languages, right? But to speak that language, we need to set the words. Each word, when you mix it together, a meaningful words, you mix it together, then it becomes a sentence. In this particular poem also, the poet is telling that English is a very beautiful language and it is a game type language also. You can use very thoughtful words and make it a beautiful language. So, in this particular poem, what the poet says, let us go through the poem. Okay, children? So, let's go. The title of the poem is The Wonderful Words. You speak, you learn to speak different languages, right, children? So, in this particular poem also, the poet is telling that how thoughtful your words should be, how to speak with others, how to coordinate with others, how to communicate with others, how to set the words, how to speak, how to present yourself so that the opposite person can understand you very carefully. They love to listen to you, right, children? So let us go through this particular poem. Oh, never let a thought shrivel and die. Whatever thoughts you have, sometimes children, we are saying to you, we are explaining you, teachers are also teaching you that whatever thoughts you have, sometimes you have to write down in a diary, right? Good thoughts you are marking down in a diary. Good proverbs are there. Good idioms are there that you all are marking down in diary. Never let that thoughts burn. Never let your thoughts die. Whatever thoughts, good thoughts are coming, note down in a book. It is good memory. Right, children? For want of a way to say it, for English is a wonderful game. You know, the puzzle, the jumble words, they all are the English word is itself a wonderful game and all of you can play it. It is very easy to set the in your first standard, in your second standard, in your KG nursery children, the alphabetical orders are being taught to you, right? You know how first the teachers teach you and then afterwards you yourself will set the words into an alphabetical order. The same way, whatever thoughts are coming in your mind, you place it in a proper order. All that you do is match the words. You know, subject and predicate also you are learning in grammar, right? There are different kinds of words. Without the meaningful words, how you can form a sentence, children? The poet is telling that if you want to form a wonderful language, a wonderful sentence, your words also should be adjusted wonderfully. Then only it will be understood by the opposite person, right? To the brightest thoughts in your head, the thoughts, how your thoughts are, the same way you will present the word. If your thoughts are evil, you will not be able to present yourself in front of the people. But if your thoughts are good, very easily, a simple language also you will speak, the opposite person will understand. Right, children? So, what the poet is telling, to the brightest thoughts in your head, always the positivity should go in your head. The positive thoughts should always sparkle in your head so that they come out clear and true, as I said. What the thoughts are, you present the thoughts in a very simple and easy language that it is very clear and the opposite person also believes you, trust you. That way you have to represent yourself. And handsomely groomed and fed. Groomed means the words, the texture of the words also should be presented so nicely that for many of the loveliest things have never yet been said. There are many different kinds of words, children. New words you can take out. From that new words, you can make a beautiful language. Many children have the hobby to write down the wonderful poems. Any language, it is not compulsory that English only. Some children are very good writers, some children are very good poets. For that particular thing also, you are trying to fetch different types of words in your mind. Right, children? The same way the poet is telling, if your thoughts are good, the words will be clear, the words will be true, and whatever words you are setting, it will be lovely, felt very lovely in presence of the people. Right? Words are the food and dress of thoughts. Children, always teachers teach you, speak the truth. Your attitude, your presentation of your body, your texture of your body says how the dressing code is, it represents you that what type of a person you are. So always your language should be very polite, very good. Your thoughts also should be very positive. Understood, children? They give it its body and swing. Right, children? And everyone's longing, eager today to hear. Everybody, if your presentation is powerful, if opposite person is feeling very positivity in you, every morning, every day, today Krupali Miss class is there. No, we all want to attend the class. Wow, she's explaining very nicely. That type of you children has to present the attitude. The opposite person should know you. Some fresh and beautiful thing. Every time some motivational things will be taught to you, some good things will be taught to you, and you will be very eager to know that particular things. But only words can free a thought. Don't keep it everything in your mind. Try to represent yourself. Try to be open in front of the people, but your words should be very controlled and polite. From its prison behind your eyes, don't keep it in your mind. Don't think lots of negative thoughts, right? Maybe your mind is holding now a marvelous new surprise. Maybe your some thoughts, some words will be very useful to the opposite person, for the people to whom you are speaking to, and they get some inspiration from you, they get some strength from you. Right, children? So always what you think, that should be applied. So think very positively, think very truthfully, and be very true and be very pure. The writer of this poem is Marionelle, she is a very wonderful poet. How nicely she has expressed the thoughts, the words, and that's why only this particular poem is known as The Wonderful Words. I hope so you children have understood. Have a nice day.